Hello everyone, this will be a step 2 of the part 1, view filters and visibility graphic overrides for view filters. So we, in the previous session you can see on my screen, we've created a couple of view filters. And in this session I want to apply those view filters and then set visibility graphic overrides for them. So we have our view filters created over here. So let's just say you wanted to apply those view filters to a view. You will go to a view dropdown over here, and then you can use that very first node over there up there. It's called add filter. And it has two inputs. The first input is a view filter. We already have these two created. And the second input is a view itself. So in our case, we want to apply it to two views. Both of these views have fire rating in their name. So there's a couple of different ways we can go about selecting those views to use them with our view filter. The easiest way, and if you only got one or two views, I would probably recommend doing that. If you search for a node called views, this dropdown will be populated with all of the views in the project, and you can literally just select one, and then, I've got categories in my selection, and then you can just copy paste this, select the second one. So these are your views. So if you're applying those view filters to a single view or two views, this probably makes sense because you can just list create and combine them together into a list. And then you can use that list as an input into your view filters. However, I want to make this example as flexible as possible, and I'm making an assumption that you will have more than two views. And it actually makes more sense to set up a rule for how you want to select these views. So instead of using this particular combination of nodes, I'm going to move this out of the way a little bit. I'm going to do something else. I'm going to use a custom node that I've set up called viewGetByType. And then we're going to set up a filter. So the input into this is a view type. So if you scroll down a little bit, there is a dropdown called view type. So I know that my views are floor plans. So I'm going to just search for a floor plan and plug it into view. If I just use a watch node really quickly to visualize what we have so far, you can see there's all of the floor plans in the project. And the last two are the fire rating floor plans that we're interested in, right? So we can set up a filter to get these views consistently. So if you're working on a project when there's like 60 floor plans that you're checking the fire rating for, this will be the way to go. What's our rule? Well, I want to collect any view that has fire rating in its name. So let's just search for element.name node. And then this returns a string. You can see that over here. This returns a string with the name of the view. So we can use string.contains to basically weed out the ones that don't. So we're going to plug that string into there, and then we're searching for a substring, and then in this case our substring is fire rating. And then the third input is a boolean value, but that has a default on it, so you can see that the state of the node changed and it's actually working. So what does it return? It returns a list of true and false values, and you can see that the first three values are false because those are the first three floor plans, and then the last two are the ones that we're actually looking for that contain fire rating in their name, and then those are set to true. So we can use that pattern with node called list.filter, and then if you click over here, well, actually, I'm sorry, it's list.filter by boolean mask. It's that second one on the list. So this will be our mask. This is the pattern of true and false. And if we take all of our views and feed that in, it will basically split those views into two lists. And you can see those here. And the first one, which is the output from the in output, is the two views that we're interested in. So we can take that. I'm just going to move this out of the way a little bit. Clean up my space a little bit here. Okay, there you go. Let's just move this up here. See everything a little bit clearer. Okay, so the two views that we're interested in are in the in, and we can plug that into our view. And then we have a view filter. So if I wanted to apply both of these view filters to both of the views that were collected over here, or to all of the views that were collected over there, I will have to combine them into another list. And then we can use that list with our view filters. So what should happen right now is both of these views should have both of these filters added to them. So let's just really quickly have a look. And you can see that these two filters were added to that view. And then they were also added to this view. So now the last step would be to set some visibility graphics, because we want to highlight these walls probably with two different settings. For that, we would use a set filter visibility node. And, well, actually, I'm sorry. We'll talk about this a little later. It's set filter overrides. So for that, there's a couple of inputs. First, we need our view. So we would actually take both of these views, just like before, and then we would take a view filter, and we're going to set up different visibility settings for each one of the filters. So it's not the list over here, but instead it's the output from the create filter node. So we're going to set up the first one, which is the 1 hour array wall. So that will be our view filter. And then the last input here is graphics settings. And that's the override graphics settings node that you can find over here. And there's a couple of things that we can do over here. First of all, if you take these node, and you notice probably that right away it has that darkish gray color to it, that means that all of these inputs have default values to them. What that does is, if I took a view filter and plug this graphic settings into it, this basically resets all of the settings. So it sets them to default for all the override graphics. It basically removes all the graphic overrides for this filter. The minute we start plugging some things into it, that's when the visibility graphic overrides kick in, and this node starts acting as an overrider rather than just resetter. So really quickly, a couple of inputs here, and these are very similar to what you will see with the UI. What I want to do is just a simple override of the color of the fill pattern. So first we need to create a color, and again, I'm going to use a shortcut by double clicking on canvas and creating a code block, and I'm going to say for the 1 hour array, I want to make them orange. So I'm just going to type in orange. I'll declare a variable, say orange equals, and I'm going to type in color dot by ARGB, and I'm going to open parentheses. I'm going to say 0 for A, and then 255 for red, and then let's just say 165 for green, 0 for blue. And I'm going to close my parentheses and end the line with a semicolon. So this should create a color. You can see that over here. So I'm going to plug that color into my fill color. And then overriding a fill color is not enough. If you want to display a fill color over it, you also have to give it a pattern, because otherwise it just displays by, it's just set to none. So what's a fill pattern? You can find those right here on top. So these are all the fill patterns available for you in the project, so I like to use a solid fill. And I'm overriding a cut fill pattern. So these two inputs all by themselves are enough to override this filter settings, and I think we should see that already, yes. So you can see that both of our plans already have a filter color override associated with them. And if we just go to filters over here, you can see that the pattern color has been overridden. It has a color and has a fill, it's a solid fill pattern. So we can keep going and add a red color override for the other one. So again, we're just gonna set filter overrides. And then we're gonna need a new graphics overrides node. So for this one, I wanna create a different color. I'm gonna call this red. And again, I'm going to do color dot by ARGB. And I'm just going to use 255 for red and then 0 for green and blue. So this will be my color for the fill color. And I can use the same pattern for my fill pattern. And again, I can plug that into graphics override. And then this will be my override for the second filter. And the views are going to be the same views that we've used before. So now if we minimize our view, you should see that all of a sudden both of our patterns have an override. So, and both of these are being applied to all the views. So we basically have a unified filter overrides for both of the, for all of the views. A couple of things that you can do with those overrides. I'm just going to slide my screen over a little bit so we can see some of the graphics, graphical changes. I'm going to close this menu really quickly. A couple of things we can do over here. I'm just going to go through some of the inputs. So we can set our halftone for these overrides, and that would be a Boolean input. So setting it to false means that there is no halftone applied, but if you check it to true, you can see that the halftone setting has been applied. I usually keep this at false. A detail level input, it doesn't do anything for view filters, so you don't have to worry about this one. This is a detail level that you would set for categories, and we'll talk about that in the next video. There's also transparency. That's a setting that we can set between 1 and 100. That will be an integer slider. For transparency. And you can see that you can change the transparency of the wall just by toggling it. Or not. Just keep it set to 0. There's also line pattern. That would be another node available in the library here over left, called line pattern. And these are all the available line patterns. So if you wanted to set your cut line pattern to be hidden, you can do that as well. You can override the cut line weight, for example, and these are values if you hover over this between 1 and 16. So again, maybe an integer slider. And you can expand this and tap it off at 16 and start it at 1, so you never go over. And you can basically play around with these, and they can be really thick or really thin. So have a play with that. And the rest of them are exactly the same as the ones that we did for cut, but these are for the projection settings. And you can probably notice that just because the door fire rating isn't really showing, even though if I clicked on this door, and it has settings set to 1, so the filter should be picking it up because we already added doors and walls to our filters. And that's because we're overriding only the cut lines, not projection lines. So if I wanted to override the projection line weight, and I made this door just because we're looking at this specific door, and we're overriding the 2-hour rated ones, you can see that, yes, it's working for the doors as well. It's just that all of these lines were projection lines, not the cut lines. And you can also set the color for the projection line color, so you can see that, yes. These are the doors that are 2-hour rated. There's one more thing we can do that I already dropped in before, and that's the view set filter visibility. So this particular node allows you to, we're just gonna grab that view, and we're going to grab our view filters. Let's just grab both of them at once. And by default, this node is set to true, but we can use a Boolean toggle to basically hide the view filters. So this setting, you can toggle between true or false, and it's the same thing as an equivalent of just unchecking these boxes here. So keep that in mind. That's all I wanted to showcase for the view filter visibilities, graphical overrides. We went through parameters, we went through categories, multiple filters, multiple views. In the next session, we're going to talk about how to remove view filters and remove them from both multiple views at the same time and or the project, just delete them out of the project altogether. So stay tuned, and I'll see you in the second session.